Bhubaneswar and Chahar are still not there, but you still have quality backups in Thakur, who won you the Cuttack match, and of course Saini, which you've seen a lot of them develop at RCB as well. So how do you see that incredible depth in bowling? You've spoken about in the test format as well, the backup, but how do you see it for T20I as well, like with Thakur and Saini?
Yeah, it's good to have, as I said, these guys have played a lot of T20 cricket. Saini is a different case because he's come from the domestic setup into the IPL and into the Indian team. So he has bowled quite a bit, has good understanding of lines and lengths, and he's obviously got pace. Thakur again has played a lot of T20 cricket, he's been playing the IPL for a while, and is quite experienced in that regard. Bhuvi, Bumrah, we don't really have to discuss. Shami is again someone who will always stay in the mix. And Deepak Chahar has bowled really well, you know, for the number of games that he's played. So I think because the tournament is in Australia, you will need these many options and backups ready to be able to take firstly your strongest 11 or strongest squad, and then have those backups in place who also can come and do the job. So yeah, it's good that we have identified 5 or 6 guys, and it'll be priority based on, you know, who goes, and then backups will be in place also. With the fast bowlers, we know small niggles can happen every now and then. So yeah, we're pretty sorted in that regard. Not a worry at all.
Last two. Virat, what's your reading of the pitch here in Barsapara? What kind of match will you see? Will it be
high scoring match? Yeah, I believe it's going to be high scoring. The pitch last time we played West Indies here was really, really good pitch to bat on. And yeah, we expect the pitch to play really well, and it's going to be a challenge for the bowlers. Again, an opportunity to see which bowler, you know, reacts well under pressure situations. That's primarily our focus, whether it's batting favorable the pitch, or you know, bowler friendly. The opposite skill, we'll see interestingly how they step up. So if it's a batting friendly pitch, you know, bowlers will be tested. If it's a bowler friendly pitch and you're under pressure, batsmen will be tested. Yeah, but I think this pitch, primarily, we feel like it's going to be a high-scoring game.
Final.
There's a lot of mixed opinions about 4-day tests. What does Indian captain think of?
4-day tests?
Four-day
tests. Oh. I'm not a fan of... T20 was, you know, a revolution in introducing a new format. I was not in favor of. I was asked about the 100 ball, and I said I'm not gonna go and try myself out in another kind of format because there's already so much going on. And with Test cricket, I don't think that, you know, with day-night tests is the most that should be changed about Test cricket, according to me. I mean, then you're purely only talking about getting numbers in and entertainment, and you know. I think the intent will not be right then, because then you'll speak of 3-day tests. I mean, where do you end? Then you'll speak of test cricket disappearing. So I don't endorse that at all. I don't think that is fair to the purest format of the game, how cricket started initially. And, you know, 5-day test matches was the highest of tests you can have at the international level. So according to me, it should not be altered. As I said, day-night is another step towards commercializing test cricket and, you know, creating excitement around it, but it can't be tinkered with too much. I don't believe so.
Can I just follow up? City is hosting the match where you saw a lot of protest from CA. You have commented on demonetization when you were in there. What is your viewpoint on CA?
The city is absolutely safe. We didn't see any problems on the roads, and the issue, I do not want to be irresponsible and speak on something that has, you know, radical opinions, both sides. Need to have total information, total knowledge of what it means and what is going on, and then be responsible to give your opinion on it. Because you can say one thing and then someone can say another thing. So I would not like to get involved in something that I don't have total knowledge of. And it's not going to be responsible on my part to comment on it.